developments tonight in the botched arms sale program, Fast and Furious. Congressional investigators are now setting their sights on the Federal Bureau of Investigation for some answers. Congressman Daryl Issa, Senator Charles Grassley, sending a letter today to FBI Director Robert Mueller demanding answers about the guns found at the murder scene of Border Patrol agent Brian Terry. They wrote, quote, out of deference to the FBI's ongoing criminal inquiry, we have delayed asking the Bureau direct questions about the case for nearly 10 months. However, Congress has a right and a duty to conduct oversight of federal law enforcement operations. Joining me now, a member of the House Oversight Committee leading the investigation, Congressman Trey Gowdy joins us. Gowdy, a Republican in South Carolina, good to have you with us. What do you expect the answer to be, by the way, from the FBI to Senator Grassley and Chairman Issa?
Lou, what I think the answer is going to be is that the FBI doesn't know because the projectile, and I hate to speak in such stark, cold terms, but the projectile that killed Border Patrol Agent Terry was so distorted that they're not going to be able to do ballistics or rifling tests on it. So I think it's entirely appropriate that Senator Grassley and Chairman Issa ask, but I've had countless homicide prosecutions where the projectile is just so distorted that you can't do the test that you have to do, so you're left with an inconclusive result. I suspect that's either going to be the answer, or Director Mueller, who is widely respected on both sides of the aisle, is going to say this would jeopardize a successful prosecution.
Yeah.
Let me come give you a classified briefing and tell you why.
Well, when it comes to the murder of a U.S. Border Patrol agent, one would expect a great deal of intensity and urgency in that investigation, as well as thoroughness. I'm sure we've seen thoroughness. Urgency doesn't seem to be the case. This is we're now 10 months into this. This is, by any standard, a frustratingly long period for an investigation into a homicide, isn't it?
Yes, sir. And every day that goes by, the case gets worse. Nothing in the criminal justice system gets better with time. So my hope is that they're waiting on forensics or ballistics to seal the deal, or else the defense attorneys have asked for a continuance for some reason or the other. But 10 months to 12 months, we need to get this case resolved and let the Terry family have what I hope will begin to be some closure.
And the questions seem to just widen. For example, now a dispute by the Justice Department that there were three weapons at that murder scene, not two as first reported. And there is considerable evidence, as you well know, Congressman, that there were indeed three weapons, including the statements of an ATF agent and the gun dealer who sold at least two of the three weapons. I mean, these questions seem to be growing as the answers seem to be, frankly, not coming forward.
Yeah, there's a missing exhibit one. Whenever you work a crime scene, obviously you number what you recover. And if you have a two and a three, necessarily you have to have a one. That's part of the frustration, but really the overarching frustration that some of us feel, hopefully most of us feel, is that the Department of Justice has become excessively politicized. Right. And when you don't have confidence in the Department of Justice or the nation's top law enforcement official, we may not make it as a republic. So my hope and my expectation, although I've been disappointed thus far, is for Attorney General Holder to do now what he should have done initially, which is come before a committee of Congress, either the House or the Senate, and tell us everything he knows. If it needs to be a classified debriefing, that's fine, because it would jeopardize some ongoing investigation or prosecution. But I can tell you, as a former employee of the Department of Justice, I take no pleasure whatsoever in you and I having this conversation. But we have to have confidence in that department. And if we don't, which I don't think is too much to ask, and if we don't, we're not going to make it as a republic. So this is serious. It is not politics, despite what my colleague, Congressman Schiff, said. This is so much more important than just political shenanigans. It is about the Department of Justice.
You referenced Congressman Schiff, Congressman Adam Schiff. I want to just show our audience part of what he said in calling it a political attack on the Attorney General. Quote, the politically motivated attacks on Attorney General Eric Holder need to come to an end. They are a meritless distraction from the important work of the Department of Justice and the many men and women who work every day to make America safer. The evidence is clear, and the Attorney General has been forthright throughout. I have to ask you, Congressman, straight up, his appearance, the Attorney General's appearance before the House Judiciary Committee, was an exercise in two elements at least, contradiction of the facts as we now know them, and secondly, without question, a misrepresentation of the facts.
Yeah, I had to smile when I read Congressman Schiff use the word forthright. I was trying to think of what an antonym for forthright would be, like obfuscation or demonstrably false. And if you go on and read farther into Congressman Schiff's letter, he said that Attorney General Holder was very forthright when he learned of serious problems with Fast and Furious. Mm-hmm. All right, there are a couple of issues there, Lou. Number one, what could possibly be more serious than the death of a Border Patrol agent, which happened in December of 2010.
Congressman Schiff,
so if he's only
going to
figure this out.
Yeah, Congressman Schiff made a very unfortunate use of the word serious in that application. Congressman, we're out of time.
But he also missed...
I'm sorry, go ahead real quick.
Well, I was just going to say, he also missed the overarching issue, which is, it's not just the problems with Fast and Furious, it's Fast and Furious from its inception. It was flawed from day one.
And there's another now looming problem, and that appears to be the inability or the refusal of the U.S. Justice Department to bring forward the facts to the United States Congress. That will have to be resolved, as you well know. And we
it will be resolved.
And we thank you for being here. Good to talk with you, Congressman.
Thank you,
Trey Gowdy.
Good evening.